Hey guys, it's Magda. Welcome back to my channel. It's Saturday afternoon, about 5:30 p.m. and we're about to do the day two body challenge. My bird's talking. We're going to add some weights. We're going to start adding some weights this month, and we're going to start doing some heavier exercises. And in adding weights and doing harder exercises, we can do fewer repetitions and take less time. For somebody like me who's like really strapped on time and trying to fit a lot into a day, the less I spend with the higher result, the higher success, or the higher benefit that I can get out of it, the better for me. I would love to just be 45 minutes here and be done. You know, sometimes these exercises take as long as 2 hours, an hour and 45 minutes, and that's a long time. So however I can cut that down, the way I can cut that down is by adding weights, and that's what we're doing today. So this is going to be a hard workout. It seems like it's short, and it seems like short easy, but it's going to be hard. I'm introducing deadlifts today. That's a very good exercise for your thighs, your calves, your entire legs, your glutes, all of that, all your lower body. We're going to do the Russian twists. These are so hard, but my abs feel better today, so I might as well shred them again. We're going to do some bridges with kicks. That's a new thing, just like doing add an extra benefit to the bridge. We're working the glutes a lot today. 10 of my half push-ups. We're going to eventually shortly start working up to a real push-up, but that's going to be a whole process that we mentioned yesterday. And 15 wood chops with a 15-pound weight. I'm doing 10 deadlifts with two 10-pound plates, plus the bar is 10 pounds. So I wrote 20 pounds here because I used two 10-pound plates, but this doesn't factor in the bar, which is another 10. So we're gonna start the deadlifts with really 30 pounds, but 20 just so I know what plates I used. All right, so let's get going. Okay guys, we're gonna start with 10 deadlifts today. I've never done a deadlift before. That's why I didn't want to go too heavy on the weight. I know my legs are strong, but a deadlift is also about the correct form. And until I get used to them, I don't want to hurt myself. You can really injure your back if you do them incorrectly. So I watched some videos on how to do them. I have a mirror over there just so I'm kind of keeping track of what I'm looking like. This is just like an extra little move that I'm adding to work my arms a little. You have to be very aware to be using your buttocks and your legs for this. Don't be using your back at all. Your hips are supposed to be higher than your knees. I'll get it, it's gonna take some practice. I can tell I'm using my legs and my butt. Nothing in my back is hurting at all. Ow, I just hit my clavicle. I think that's 10 guys, maybe 11. So that's our first circuit, just 10, part of the first circuit, 10 deadlifts. So I don't know if I mentioned, if you guys are new here, what I showed you there is just one circuit. So I repeat that 5 times, but I just do one circuit with you guys, not to make this video 2 hours long. So that's 10 deadlifts to start. Next is 20 Russian twists. Boy, this is only the second time I'm doing these. These really killed me last time. These really, really hurt. But that's the point. All right. My abs are still a little sore, but they were better, so. All right. 2.
13, 14, 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
that's 20. Wow, that's good. I'm glad I didn't drop my legs, even though the form wasn't perfect. 20 bridges with kicks. Now, I haven't done this before, so I'm not sure what that's going to look like, but let's take a look. So, we got our basic bridge, right? Our basic bridge, and then you're supposed to go like this, I guess. Yeah, I can see how that's harder. Kind of a good stretch. I don't know how many that is. I think that's maybe 8. I mean 6. I'm not sure how it's supposed to go. I should look that up again. I guess you can do it this way too. I think that's at least 10. What did I say I'm gonna do? Those are much harder. 20. All right. Yeah, I can definitely see more of a benefit to those than just the basic bridge. Do I love them? No. But that's okay. We're not gonna love every exercise. Weirdly, they hurt my neck. I think that's 6. 7. 8, 9, 10. That's 20. Not a fan. Somehow pulling on my shoulders and my neck. We'll see if that hurt me in any way. Don't need a broken neck. Next, we're going to do 10 half push-ups. A whole separate workout is going to have to be working up to a real push-up. A whole separate circuit. I really need like 48 hours in every day. Okay. So just the half push-ups, guys. These aren't bad. Those have gotten, even those were hard in the beginning, those have gotten a heck of a lot easier since the beginning. So there's definitely some muscle growing. Okay, and the last little thing is 15 wood chops with the 15-pound weight, which is the heavier of the two that I've been using so far. Sorry, still coughing. Slow and controlled. Mm. So like I said, with the weights, we'll be able to do less work, more work, but in less time, which is exactly what I need. There's a phrase or a word that I'm thinking of, and it's driving me crazy. Like when you have a set daily routine and you decide someday, some random time of day, you decide, no, I'm not going to do this part of my routine. I'm going to do something completely different and go off of your routine to do something different one day. What is that called? When you break your routine to do something else. It's like a phrase I'm thinking of or a word. Christine, come through for me. Christine, my VIP. I know you know this. I'll be waiting for a message. I think that's at least 15. Let's switch sides. I really like the wood chops. So we just did a complete upper, middle, and lower body workout in 5 moves. And that's exactly gonna be my focus this month. A total body workout, hard work, add weights, and we're gonna get the most bang for our buck. I think that's at least 10, 5 more. Okay. Okay. Awesome. I'm already starting to pour sweat, which is great. So that's the routine, guys. That's today's routine. I'm loving it. I really like this one. This one is a really, really good one. I'm psyched. I'm psyched for this month. This is only our day 2. Thank you for being here. I'm going to continue with this circuit. Look at that's amazing. Just from one little 12 minutes of work, I'm pouring sweat. I'm going to continue work. I'm going to do my little, as I've been telling you, my little bit of elliptical 10 minutes, then back to this, then elliptical, back to this. It's a great workout. And I have a walk to look forward to, and I know it's Saturday. What was Friday? What didn't we do yesterday? And there was a reason I didn't do it yesterday. I just wasn't in the mind frame. Like, I need to be in a positive, good headspace. And at the moment when I was coming home, I wasn't that. So I didn't stop to buy our scratch tickets, our $20 worth of scratch tickets. We have a $25 winner from last week, so we won't be spending any money this week. I'm going to be taking $5 back, so that's awesome. But I'm in a great headspace, so after my walk, I'm going to pop out and get a couple scratch tickets for us, and we'll scratch them tomorrow. It's weird, I'm working and I'm busy, but it does feel like a weekend somehow. So I'm in a good frame of mind today. I'm happy. Anyway, so here's to day 2. We're going to smash it. Thank you for being here. Thanks for hanging out. And I love you guys, and I'll see you guys so soon. Bye.